यस सर, इट स्टार्टेड।
ओके रोहिंग्या मैम, शैल आई स्टार्ट? रोहिंग्या मैम,
यस सर, आई थिंक यू शुड स्टार्ट सर,
ओके ओके मैम,
बिकॉज ऑलरेडी इट्स 1:20 एंड वी हैव गिवन टाइम 1 o'clock।
ओके मैम।
थैंक यू।
It is an honor and great elation for me to welcome you all on behalf of Library Committee in today's ENLIST program. I extend my warm welcome to our worthy principal, Dr. Ajit Gupta in absentia, HOD PG department, Dr. Murai Sharma in absentia, and HOD UG department, Dr. Rohinika Sharma, Deputy HODs, faculty members, and dear students. Today we are here to learn how to use ENLIST services. Since it is a paid one and our institution is paying annually so that both staff and students could avail its facilities. With the permission of Dr. Rohinika Sharma, I would like to start my presentation now. Utilization of
sure.
Yes.
Sure. Sunil ji, continue with your presentation.
Okay. Utilization of e-resources through UGC's ENLIST program. I will tell you something about the ENLIST. ENLIST is a National Library and Information Services infrastructure for scholarly content. Its center is Infinite Center is in Gujarat, Gandhinagar. And it is backed up by IIT Delhi. This is a project. It is jointly executed by the UGC InfoNet Digital Library Consortium, InfoNet Center, and the Indest AICT Consortium, maintained by IIT Delhi, which I have already told you. It provides access to more than 6,000 e-journals. And more than 1,64,000 plus e-books are here. You can access these books through ENLIST. You can write down the ENLIST infilimnet.ac.in and enter your username and password. List of e-resources subscribed under the ENLIST program will displayed. I will tell you how setup by setup how you cache the website. You have to write first ENLIST.infilimnet.ac.in. Then you have to click the right side of your desktop, registration members login. Your username is first name dot roll number at the rate of myercollege.in, which you know it is a college email address of you all students. And you will get your password through email when you activate the email. You have not yourself to registered in the ENLIST. We have already registered all of you, faculty members and also the students. And the link, ENLIST has sent already the link on your email. You have only to activate the link and you will get the password. Here is a registered members login. You have to click here, login, and you will get this page. Here are the e-resources. You have to click the e-resources, or the e-resources under the ENLIST program will displayed. When you open any website, it will ask also second time your username and password. You have to put your username and password, and then you can access the desired journal or an ebook. For this, let us have a live demonstration on ENLIST through Isha Sharma. Now I will request Isha to present the ENLIST website, how they can access the e-journals and e-books. Isha Sharma. Isha, share the screen, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your wonderful presentation. Now, moving ahead. Is it visible, sir?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Now, you have to type your NList address in the address bar. This is the home page of NList. That is National Library and Information Services Infrastructure for Scholarly Content. As sir has already told you that we, our college has subscribed this for you so that you can access the resources anywhere and anytime, right? Now, moving ahead, to access the e-resources in NList, you have to log in now. For this, you have to press this login button, which is present on the right side, right? When you will click on this, the user login window will open.
It is okay, it is okay.
Right? You yes. have to write here your username. As sir has already told you that we have registered you already in the NList. So you have to write your college email ID here, like your first name dot roll number at the rate myercollege.in, right? For that, and now you have to enter the password. For the password, you have to just check your college email ID in which NList has sent a password to you, an activation link to you. You have to write that password here. Right? You will write the password which the NList has sent to you here and then go for the login button. Right? If you want to change the password which the NList has sent to you, you will go for the forgot password. You will click on this and then you will write your email ID, that is your username, that is your college email ID. Your first name dot roll number at the rate myercollege.in, right? Now here in the recapture box, you will calculate this and write the number. Then when you'll press enter, they will send an OTP to your email ID. They will send the OTP to the email ID of your what you have entered here, right? That is your college email ID. They will send an OTP here and then you can change the password, right? Now you can change your password accordingly, whatever you want. When you set your password, then you'll again log in here by clicking on the login button. You'll enter your username and then enter the password. And then the home page of the NList will open. This is the home page of NList, right? You can see it. This is the home page here. You can see that ample number of material is available. Ample number of resources are here, like e-journals are here. More than 60,000 e-journals are here and more than 1,60,000 plus e-books are here. These are different libraries and you can search the e-books under these libraries like Cambridge Books Online, eBrary, EBS Co-host, Hindustan Book Agency and number of resources are available, right? For the search option, you can enter here whatever you want to search. I'll show you. Right now. suppose if you want to search something on philosophy, you will write here philosophy and press enter, and you will get all the suggested topics, whatever you want. And you can select accordingly whether you want religion and philosophy, history of philosophy, ethics, history and criticism, religion, etc., etc. You will get here just by writing the need, writing the content, whatever you want to search, right? Here, number of books are available. These are the books. And if you want to select this book, to read this book, you have to click on this, click to view. This ebook will be open for you. You can read this book, right? This is the book. You can read this book online, as well as you can download this book, right? Now, the best part of this, the best part of Enlist is that you can download the book chapter wise. If you don't want to download the complete book, you have to just go for the table of contents and you will select whatever chapter, whatever content you want, right? Suppose I want this one, I'll click on this and I can download this chapter through here. Download PDF. This is the chapter wise PDF. You need not to download the whole book. You can download it chapter wise accordingly. Like this one from pages 9, page number 9 to page number 15. You can download it accordingly, according to your need. Right? Now, moving further, if you want to refine your search, right? You want to narrow down the search, you want a quick result or you want a specific result, you can narrow down it by selecting some filters. Filters are present. These are on the right side, right? See, this is the narrow search and you will select here the format, whatever you want. You want ebook, then you have to click on this. Then ebook will be selected here, right? Now, if you want some conference proceedings, you will click on this. Conference proceedings will be added here, right? Now, select the language, whether I want in English, German or French. I click on English, then English language will be added in the reset filters. See, you can see that these are the filters I'm applying here and accordingly the search is changing. The contents, these are changing accordingly, according to my need. If I want some specific publication, that is from year 2000 to 2010 on from 2010 to 2020, then it will refine my search accordingly, right? That previously here number of contents are available from different years, from different publications. Now this search is showing me the publications under 2010 to 2020. That is from 2010 to 2020. See, this one is the first ebook or conference proceeding. This is published in 2013, right? Now, next one is in 2012, then again 2012, 2011. It is narrow downing my search, refining my search to save my time, that whatever I want. Now, if I don't want this one and I want to change my topic, I have to deselect them. I have to click on this, it will be deselected. I have to click on this, it will be deselected. Then again, I have to click on this and then the search accordingly has been changed, right? Now, if under philosophy, I have to select religion and philosophy and like ethics. If I want to go with ethics, the suggested topics will be changed accordingly. Now, these are the topics, these are the contents. If I want to see this book, I have to click on this and it will be open as I have shown you earlier. And you can download this book as a PDF, or you can read it online accordingly, whatever you want. If you want to select some chapters. You can see the chapters accordingly. Maybe net is slow and we'll go with another one, right? You can select as such as right now I can select it and I can select, and these fields are available like title, author, subject, whatever I want. I have to click it and select my topic under the search, and when you apply these filters, it will be these filters that are present in the right side that we have applied earlier. These are the filters to narrow down our search. So we can see it. These are the filters. If I apply these filters in my search to refine my search, then the search will be advanced, right? Now moving ahead with the other resources of NList, it covers ample number of resources like more than 160,000 ebooks and other full text material, right? These are the journals which are subscribed. You cannot view these journals anywhere else except for the NList, because these are the paid journals and our college have subscribed this for you. That is, we have subscribed the NList in FlipNet for you by paying a huge amount of money so that you can access it anywhere, anytime. You can access the resources which are present under the NList, right? Now we can see that e-journals, number of e-journals are available like American Institute of Physics, Annual Reviews, Economic and Political Weekly, Indian Journals, Institute of Physics, Justore, Oxford, whatever I want, I have to select it or I have to click it, right? If I click the Justore, it is the journal storage and number of journals, ample number of journals are present here. I have to just select my topic, right? Suppose if I write psychology, right? Then the results, they are showing that this much results are available. Today net is very slow, that's why it's taking time. So these are the resources. See, these are the search results. 6,776, 207 results are here. These are the book chapters, right? We can download it, we can save it, and we can cite this item also. So I have written the keyword psychology. So they have underlined it that this material is from psychology, and I have to select it according to my need, whether I want it or not. Again, here also, I can refine my results, refine my search by selecting the academic content, whether I want journal, whether I want book chapters. I have to click on this, and then the search has been changed accordingly. Like here, only journal articles are available. Previously, everything is coming. Now I have select the journal, so journal article is coming here, right? If I don't want journals and I click on this, I'll deselect the journal article and I'll go with the book chapters, then it will show me the book chapters, right? Now the book chapter is available. Previously, it was showing a journal article. Journal article was here. Now, as I have selected book chapters, so the search has been refined accordingly and it is showing the book chapter. Now, if I want this, I'll click on this. I can download this. This is open access for us. This is open. For others, maybe it is not open access, as our institution, our prestigious institution, has paid amount of money, large amount of money for this, so that we can access it anywhere, anytime. Now, these are the e-journals, right? Electronic journals, and these are available in full text, right? These are the journals. Now, moving ahead, with the e-books. Suppose I want some e-books, I can go for this library online. Cambridge books are available here. Ebrary books, that is 150,000 plus more titles are available here. EBSCO co-host libraries here. Hindustan Book Agency, Oxford, Springer, Sage, number of publications are available here. Right? Now, if I want to select some publication, I have to click on this. I click on the Springer ebooks, and again, as it requires my username, again, I have to write my username here. Your username will be your first name dot your roll number @mycollege.in, right? And then you have to write your password. If you have not changed your password, you will write the password which has been given by NLIST to you in your registered email ID. You will write that password. And if you have changed your password, you can write your new set password by you. And then if you have entered your username as well as the password, you can see the ebooks by Springer publication. Right? Now, this is the search result, right? As I have not selected any content type from here, content type is available in the left side. This is the homepage of Springer, right? This is the homepage of, you can see that Springer link is written here, and this is the homepage of Springer, right? This is the homepage of Springer, as I can download as many books as I want. Now, again, the content type. If I want the book, I can select the book. If I want conference proceedings, I'll click on the conference proceedings, reference work. Now, discipline. Discipline here is the subject name, your subject, whatever you want. You want computer science, engineering, or whatever subject you want, you will select from here, right? If I'll go with computer science, and then moreover, I want a sub-discipline. Under sub-discipline, I want a topic like artificial intelligence under computer science. So I will select here the computer science and then the artificial intelligence. Now, the search has been refined automatically, right? This is the search, and I can view the documents. I can view the books as well as conference proceedings here. These are the material which is available according to my search. See, 2,582 results. 2,582 results are available in computer science and with artificial intelligence. You can select anywhere, anything, whatever you want according to your need. If I want this, I have to click on this, and then this book has been opened for me, and I can download this here. By clicking on the download book PDF, I can download this book. Again, table of contents are also available, and about these other volumes are also available, right? So I can download it accordingly. Chapter wise, I can also download it, and I can download the whole book, right? Now, this one is about the Springer books. Likewise, if I want some other book, like from Sage Publications, again, I have to select that and then click on this, and then I can search accordingly whatever I want to search. So this is the homepage of Sage Publications. See, previously I have shown you the homepage of Springer. Now this is the homepage of Sage Publications. So here, whatever you want, you will write here and you can search, right? Now, again, see, these are number of resources are available here. These are the e-journals and these are the e-books. As I have shown you one or two as a sample, you will select anything, whatever you want, whatever search or whatever content you want. Either you want in e-journals or you want as a e-book or conference proceeding, whatever you want, you can search it, right? So this is all about with the NList, and these are the all resources which are present under NList. And you can ask if you want to ask anything.
Okay, Shai Sharma, you have vividly given your presentation to the students, and now I think that they are able to access the e-resources. Now I request HOD UG department, Dr. Rohanika Sharma, to kindly give inputs about NList program. Dr. Rohanika Sharma, please.
Thank you, Sunil ji. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you all understood the mechanism of NList, and Isha ma'am very nicely she has explained each and every step. I congratulate Mr. Sunil Kumar Bhatt and Isha ma'am for conducting this orientation program for the student, though it is a paid version. But I must thank to the college, that college is paying for it on behalf of all the faculty and students. So being a part and parcel of this very college, being a faculty member and you people being students, you are lucky enough that somebody is paying on your behalf and you are able to access the services of NList. So I congratulate to the team library committee, and I thank all the students also for joining this program. But I am very much upset to see that out of 180 students from UG department, only 69 students are here. I don't know why other students are not joining. What is the reason? Because these kinds of program are very much important, because they are going to add so much to your knowledge, to your information. So do join and be attentive and try to, you know, log in and create your logins and register yourself, so that being a scholar, you will be able to, you know, enhance your knowledge, and you are able to access all the NList resources. With these words, I thank you one and all. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Rohanika Sharma, for your nice words. Now I request Isha Sharma to please present a formal vote of thanks. Isha Sharma, please.
Ji, sir. Thank you. It gives me an immense pleasure to convey vote of thanks on behalf of Library Committee, Maya College of Education. First and foremost, I would like to thank our worthy Principal and Director, Maya College of Education, Dr. Adit Gupta, in absentia, for his continuous support. His guidance has always encouraged us. I extend my thanks to our heads, deputy heads of PG and UG department, and all staff members of Maya College of Education for gracing the occasion. I also extend my thanks to all the students for patient listening. Last but not the least, I am thankful to each and everyone who is involved directly or indirectly for making this event a great success. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you so much. With these words, I request to HODs to leave the program, and also students can leave now. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sunil ji.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.